Hi, in this video, we will cover aspects relating to a very common orthopedic procedure, a hip replacement. We will speak about why you might need one and what the procedure involves. In terms of the procedure itself, we will speak about aspects relating to what you can expect before the operation, what you can expect on the day of the operation, what the risks are that are involved, what the outcomes are, and finally, the rehabilitation and regaining full function of your affected hip.
Joint is a ball and socket type of joint and can move smoothly in many directions. However, in conditions when the hip joint is affected, the normal movements of the joint can also be affected. Osteoarthritis commonly affects the hip joint, causing pain, stiffness, and trouble walking. A hip replacement involves replacing the original ball and socket joint with a man-made one called a prosthesis. Non-surgical methods are often employed where possible, and often whilst the patients are awaiting their date for surgery. These include weight loss, maintenance of a healthy diet as much as the patient can afford, physiotherapy, use of an assisted device such as a cane or a walker, use of pain relieving medications, and sometimes steroid injections into the painful hip. However, if these non-surgical methods fail and the pain and disability is progressive, surgery is indicated and is the next step. Surgery will offer much better function and improved quality of life after the operation. What you can expect 24 hours before the operation is hospital admission, where you will have a pre-operative checkup done by the anesthetist and the orthopedic surgeon. Blood and any other routine tests will be done to make sure you are fit for surgery. And at least 8 to 10 hours before the operation, you will not be allowed to eat or drink. On the morning of the operation, the anesthetist will put you to sleep, will give you adequate pain medication and antibiotics. They will also be sure to monitor your vital functions such as your heart rate and your blood pressure throughout the operation, so you will be in good hands. The operation itself involves the surgeon making a cut along the skin either on the front, side, or back of the hip. The old hip will be then taken out of its socket and the neck or the top of the long thigh bone will be cut. An appropriate prosthesis or a man-made hip will be then fitted and replace the part of the bone which was cut out. Although this is a safe procedure that is commonly done, there are inherent risks to any surgery. In a hip replacement, they include fracture of the long thigh bone, injury to the nerves and or blood vessels in the region, probability of developing a blood clot after the operation or an infection, and lastly, dislocation of the hip joint after the operation. However, it is important to remember that the outcome of this operation is very good, with over 90% of patients reporting pain-free, satisfactory outcomes with no complications. Rehabilitation is an important component of your care after your operation. It starts while you're still in the hospital and continues for a long time after you're discharged. The physiotherapist will give you exercises to help you regain movement at the hip. You will then get the most appropriate assisted walking device to help you mobilize, and you will have multiple follow-up appointments for the first year after your operation at different times. Initially you'll have at 3 weeks, then at 6 weeks, then at 3 months, then at 6 months, and then at 12 months with your orthopedic surgeon, and these are all off different time zones after your initial operation. Once you've had all these follow-ups for the first year, from the second year onwards, you will only have to follow up once every single year to make sure that the hip is functioning correctly.
Thank you very much for watching our video on hip replacements. I hope it was informative.